Welcome to Tool School Episode 5. I'm David, the intern from Framework Television. So, you're going to develop a website, but where do you start? Do you open your text editor and start writing HTML? Do you draw a picture of what you want it to look like? Maybe you open Photoshop. Today on Tool School, we'll talk about website prototypes and, of course, the tools you need to create them. The web prototyping process begins with creating a low-fidelity, essentials-only design to find out more about the user's wants and needs. Prototyping is an iterative process in which your prototypes become more high-fidelity and detailed with each attempt. As the process completes, you should have a full working model of the website you're creating. You should have a buy-in from the users and clients on the design. The process usually starts with good old pencil and paper. If you're not much of an artist, then you need uistencils.com. This site sells great stencils for creating website designs on paper. Their website stencil kit contains all the common icons and objects you need to design a site. It's a little on the expensive side at $36, but if you do a lot of web design, it's a tool you'll use every day. UiStencils.com also sells sketchpads specifically designed for the prototyping process. Also, if you're prototyping for Android, iPhone, or just about any other platform, there is a stencil set that will help you. Once you have your ideas on paper and enough feedback from your users and customers, it's time to turn on the computer and create a higher fidelity model. For some, however, hand drawing is just not their thing. One of the tools used instead of pencil and paper is Envision Freehand. Envision Freehand has dozens of neat features that will allow you to quickly create prototypes by drawing on the screen. Freehand shape detection features allow you to move quickly through ideas, since you don't have to worry about drawing straight lines or perfect shapes. By either hand drawing or using a tool like Envision Freehand, you can quickly move through a number of ideas. It's not where you're going to complete your final design. For that, you need different tools. Balsamiq is one of the most mature tools out there. Balsamiq has a number of features that make prototyping easy. It has a large library of UI controls that can be included in your design, making it easy to standardize your interface. Balsamiq also has a number of templates that provide a great starting point for your prototype. There are templates for homepages, landing pages, checkout pages, and much more. Mock Plus is another great tool, available at mockplus.com. Mock Plus also has a number of different UI controls that you can use in your mockup. It also features a drag and drop interface, making Mock Plus very fast to work with. Mock Plus is not web-based, so you have to download and install the software, which works on Mac, Windows, or Android devices. If you're looking for a super minimalist option, you should check out wireframe.cc. The wireframe.cc interface is simple and has almost no learning curve. Just draw a frame, decide what you want to put inside it, and then position it within the wireframe. Wireframe.cc is great for quick prototypes and provides a great starting point for both web and mobile applications. Wireframe.cc doesn't have all the features of some of its competitors, but it gets you moving very quickly. Of course, some choose to use no prototyping software at all, and instead create a working mockup using HTML code and CSS. If you're a proficient coder, this can be very efficient because as you develop your prototype, you're creating the scaffolding of your website project. This is becoming a very crowded category, and there are dozens of tools you can try for prototyping, including Adobe's XD prototyping tool, which comes with the Creative Cloud. What's your process for prototyping? Do you do paper prototypes? Do you use anything we haven't covered in this video? Let us know in the comments. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe, and let us know what you'd like to see next on Tool School. I'm David Katz. See you next time.